And so I propose to you, before we embark on this journey, that we look at the moment at this physical phenomenon that is the only way through which music expresses itself, and that is sound. Now, when people speak about sound, they speak very often in terms of colors. This is a bright sound. This is a dark sound. This is very subjective. What is dark for one is light for the other, and vice versa. But there are some elements of sound which are not subjective, and I think that, if you'll allow me to, I would like to spend a few minutes on that. If sound is a physical phenomenon, which it obviously is, then one should be able to observe it as such in a very discerning and in a very rational way. The first thing we notice about sound, of course, is that it doesn't live in this world. Whatever concert took place in this hall earlier today or yesterday, the sounds have evaporated. They are ephemeral. So, although sound is a very physical phenomenon, it has some inexplicable metaphysical hidden power. The physical aspect that we notice first is that sound does not exist by itself, but has a permanent, constant, and unavoidable relation with silence. And therefore, the music does not start from the first note and goes on to the second note, etc., etc., but the first note already determines the music itself, because it comes out of the silence that precedes it. Added to that, some instrument, percussion instruments primarily, and the piano is one of them, have a real-life duration. In other words, and it's over. Other instruments, like the violin, or the oboe, or a brass instrument, non-percussive instruments, one can, and one does, manage to sustain them longer than the real-life duration of a sound as compared to a percussion instrument. And therefore, the beginning, the first sound, is already in relation to the silence that precedes it. You must forget for a moment, please, that there are such things as technologically developed devices which permit to maintain the sound, artificially so. And this is no ungratefulness to the radio, to the recordings, to the CDs and all other means that we have to preserve the unpreservable. But the fact remains that when you, even in the old days, when you had a gramophone recording and you put the needle on the record, the sound was suddenly there. And then there was a sound. Now we go directly into the sound, but it gives us no idea whatsoever about how this is produced.